Hello students, today I am going to discuss the common operations in this session. So I am going to discuss first of common operation, which is traversal. Traversal, as I told you, we are going to take the example of arrays. So we are clear with the topic called as arrays, which is arrays is a homogeneous collection of data elements. You need to remember, it is homogeneous collection of data elements. When I say homogeneous, it is nothing but same kind of data elements. If you are going to store it in a place, which is called as arrays. When you consider arrays as an example, so arrays an example of your non-primitive data structure. So we have homogeneous data structure where the elements are stored sequentially. If the elements are stored in a sequential order, we'll consider it as arrays, which will be of homogeneous data elements. And we can remember, like, elements index will be always starting from 0 and it will end at n-1, where n will represent the number of elements. It will start from 0 and it will end at n-1, where n will represent the number of elements you're going to have. So I'll take a simple example. Say if I create an array called integer a of 5, that is nothing but I can store 5 elements of integer data type into a variable called as a. And if I represent it in a form of an array, we're going to write something like this, where the array name is a, starting index will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So static index will be 0, which will be the first index, and last index will be n-1, which is 4. As you know, the number of elements I can store is 5, so which will be representing the list of elements we have, which is 5 elements. Now, when I say traversal, traversal is nothing but accessing the data elements in the data structure, we'll consider it as traversal. So hope that is clear. Traversal is nothing but the process of accessing the elements from the data structure, we'll call it as traversal. And so we are taking the example of array, and I've discussed what is the meaning of array, what is the brief discussion about array, and how the array will look. And suppose I have inserted some elements into the array, like 20, 40, 50, again 20, and have given some elements like 70. So I've inserted some elements into the array. Now I need to do traversal. Traversal is nothing but I need to access the element that is stored in the array. For this, if I want to write an algorithm, like we are going to write step one. So step one, you can either start with start also, or you can write directly the other statements also. I am going to write directly the other statement. I am going to write repeat step 2 when I equals to 0 to n-1. So that is, I want to repeat this step called as 2 for I equals to 0 to n-1. What is that step 2? Step 2 will be like, I am going to print the value of a of I, as well as I'm going to increment the value to I equal to I plus 1. So these are the two things that I'm going to do in this step called as step 2. So in the step 2, I'll be printing the value of a of I, and I'll be incrementing the value of a of I. And again, at last you can write the statement like stop. Before stop, I can also write end step 1 loop. Okay. So this will be the algorithm for accessing the elements from the array, which is nothing but traversal. So traversal is like accessing, or you can also consider visiting. So traversal is nothing but accessing or visiting the elements of the data structure at least once. All the elements should be accessed at least once. It is considered as traversal. We have taken an example of array. how to do traversal using array, we have written with an example of a algorithm. So first step represents a for loop, where for it will start from I equal to 0 and it will end at n minus 1. And so until this condition is true, what we are going to execute? We are going to execute step 2. In step 2, what I'm doing? I'm printing the value of a and I'm also incrementing the value of I. If I want to write tracing of it, first initially I value will be what? 0. 0 is less than number of elements what we have is 4. So you can write here less than or equal to. Less than or equal to 4. I'll be executing step 2. Step 2 contains print a of I. So if I write a of 0, that is nothing but I'm going to print the value of 20. And then the second step is I will become plus 1, that is 0 plus 1, so I will become 1. So again, this step will be repeated again. So once this step will be repeated again, so I'll get I equals to 1, 1 less than or equal to 4, and this step will be continuing until I reaches 5. Once I reaches 5, 5 less than or equal to 5 will be false. In that case, we are not going to execute step 2, we are going to directly execute step 3, which will be like stop. So this is about the first function in your common operations that is based on non-primitive data structure, which have taken the example of array, and we have represented how the traversal will be working in the form of arrays. Okay, so next function we are going to discuss is like regarding next function, which will be like insertion. Insertion is, I'm going to just explain what is insertion and how to execute the insertion. So just let me clear this. I'll take the same example. I have the array with 5 elements. So I'm going to erase all these definitions and other things. So next, this function, what we are going to discuss is like, now I want to explain about insertion. What is insertion? Insertion is when you want to add a new element into the existing data structure. In the sense, already we have created an array called as a, in that we are storing 5 elements. Now for example, I want to add a new element. I want to add a new element at a specific position. Consider these are the index values, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the index values. I'm representing it as index. As you know, index will start from 0. If I consider position, this will be first position, second position, third position, fourth position and fifth position. Okay, so suppose I want to add a new element. I want to add a new element. So I want to add a new element. Suppose that element is, say, 30. That element I want to insert is 30. And I want to insert that element at position 2. So the position where I want to insert is 2. Okay, so that is nothing but if you observe the algorithm, or if you observe the this one array, we have already 4 elements. Now if I add one more element, so if I add one more element, in that case previously number of elements is 5. If I add one more element, n value should be increasing to what? 6. I need to change the size of the element, so size of the array, so that I can insert one more element, which is 6th element. So I'll just make this as, say, 10. While declaring, I'll just make that as 10. So I've inserted 5 elements. I want to insert one more element now. That element will become 6th element, or one more element, total elements will be 6. So which will, the element is 30 and the position I want to insert is 2nd position. That means to say, in this array element, array of 5 elements, I want to insert a new element 30 in 2nd position. In 2nd position, I want to insert new element. If I directly write 30 here, then 40 will be lost. If I just write a of 1 equal to 30, if I directly write like this, previously whatever element that was 40, that will be replaced by 30. That should not be done. So I need to insert a new element. That is, existing element should not be deleted. I need to add a new element. So in that case, what we are going to do is, I'm going to start, or I value will be starting with the last position. That is n minus 1. So I will start at last position. And what we are going to do is, if I write a of I plus 1 equal to a of I, just write this statement. If a of I plus 1 equals to a of I, what does that mean is, if I value is what, number of elements minus 1, that is number of elements I have is 5, minus 1 will be what, 4. So if I write I equals to 4, and if I'm trying to write a of I plus 1, that is nothing but a of 5, it is equals to a of 4. So what is the value that is present in a of 4? A of 4, I have the value as 70. So that is nothing but I'm going to have a new index called as fifth index. There I'm going to insert the value called as 70. Okay, after that again I'm going to add, or I'm going to decrement I value. I value will be reduced by 1, that is minus 1. Then I will become 3. So if I is equals to 3, then I'm going to write a of 4 equal to a of 3. In this case, whatever the value that is present in third index will be copied to fourth index. So this will become 20. And again, I'm going to write I equals to I minus 1. So it will become 2. So I is equals to 2. Again, I'm going to get I, that is say, a of 3 will be equal to a of 2. So in this case, whatever element that is present in this location, that is 2 index, will be copied to 3. Again, if you reduce the value of I will become 1. So once I reach the index I, I'll copy this value, whatever previously it was 40 to this position. So it will be 40 here. Okay. Once I reach this position, I'm going to stop this function. Why? Because now the position that I want to insert the element, and the position is second position, I want to insert the element called as 30. So which can be inserted at this position called as second position, which is 30. So this process is called as insertion. So this we are going to write in terms of an algorithm as well as a flowchart, as well as a program also. So I'm going to write the algorithm, and I'm going to explain you this statement once again. So just consider, I want to do insertion of an algorithm, or insertion of an element into the given array. I'm going to write the steps like, first step will be, step one will be like a repeat, step two and three for I equals to n minus 1 to position minus 1. Okay, next step 2 will be like, I'm going to write a of I plus 1 equals to a of I, and step 3 will be I equal to I minus 1. Here we are going to end step 1 loop. Okay, and then step 4, I'm going to increment the n value. N value will be equal to n plus 1. And step 5, we are going to write stop. Okay, so this is about the algorithm for insertion. So algorithm for inserting an element into given array, this will be the algorithm. Now we'll trace this algorithm. First, consider I have integer a of 5. I'll reduce the size, so I'll take number of elements as 3. So I'll insert only 3 elements into the array, which is like 5, 20 and some 7. Okay, so a of index value will be like 0, 1 and 2. And suppose I want to insert a new element, the element I want to insert is 10. and the position in which I want to insert, suppose it is third position. I want to insert an element at the third position. If the position is 3, just consider this is the first position, this is the second position, and this is the third position. Okay, so the position value I want to insert is 3. In the sense, in the place of 7, I want to insert now 10. Okay, now hope this is clear. We have three elements, that is 5, 20, and 7, and I want to add a new element. That new element should be inserted into a given position. That position is third position. So to make you clear, I'll just remove this position value. Why? Because if I write position equals to position minus 1, that will be like your index values. Okay, consider just position value 1, 2, 1, 3. Minus 1 if I do, that is 1, position value 1, minus 1, it will become 0. Again, position value 2, minus 1, it will become 1. So directly I'll remove this value and I'll be using only index values by reducing it to minus 1. Okay, now let's start tracing this. First, repeat step 2 and 3 for I equals to n minus 1 to position minus 1. So that is nothing but for I equals to, let us say n minus 1 is nothing but 2. Number of elements is 3, minus 1, it will be 2. Again, position from until I reaches, that is until I is less than or equal to position minus 1, that is say I'll write 2, I minus 1. That is, we have position as 3, 3 minus 1 will become 2. So until this condition is true, I need to execute these two statements, position 2 and step 2 and step 3. Step 2, this condition is true now. I have I value as 2, 2 less than or equal to 2, which is true. So if it is true, I'm going to write E of I plus 1, that is I value is 2, 2 plus 1, it will become 3, will be equal to A of I. A of I is A of 2. In the A of 2 value, what I have? The value I have is 7. In the sense, I'm going to create an array. Now it will be having 4 positions because I'm adding one more element. So now A of 0, I'm going to have 5. A of 1, I'm going to have 20. A of 2, we had 7. And in A of 3, I'm going to have 7 also. Okay. After that, we are going to reduce, I equal to I minus 1. So when I say I equal to I minus 1, I will reduce to 1. So I'll just write here I equal to 1. If I equals to 1, if you check the condition, 1 less than or equal to 2, which is false. If that is false, we are not going to execute these two statements. We're going to directly write here, come here to the step 4, where I'm going to write n equals to n plus 1. So previously n value was 3, now n value will be changing to 4. So number of elements will be 4. Now once this is done, in step 4 I can also write A of position equals to element. That is nothing but in A of 2, that is say A of position minus 1, it is A of position minus 1. Position it was 3, 3 minus 1, it is nothing but 2, in which I am going to insert the element which is 10. So I am going to write A of position minus 1 equal to element. So it is nothing but A of 2, which is equals to element, which is 10. So in the index 2, I am going to insert the element which is 10. Okay, hope this is clear. This will be your inserting an element into a given array. So about insertion, so this will be in both the chapters, in the first chapter as well as in the arrays chapter, which is fourth chapter. So again, in the next class I'll be discussing deletion as well as other thing, which is searching. Okay, thank you.